Hey everyone, it's Anson, and with macOS Sequoia on the horizon, a lot of people are asking if it's time to upgrade their Mac. In this video, I'll help you figure out which macOS version is right for you, based on the features you need and the compatibility of your Mac. I'll cover all macOS versions from Big Sur to Sequoia, and even discuss the pros and cons of running unsupported installations. First, check which version of macOS you're currently running by going to the Apple menu in the top left corner and clicking on About This Mac. You'll see your current macOS version towards the bottom. As you can see, I'm currently running Sonoma 14.6.1. Next, find out the latest version of macOS that your Mac supports by going to this compatibility chart on macsales.com. There's a link in the description. Scroll down to find the type of Mac that you're looking for, and then click on Expand to see a table listing the compatible macOS versions based on the year they were produced. A green check mark means your Mac is supported for upgrading to the listed macOS version. It's worth noting that if your Mac is supported for a macOS upgrade, you should see it listed by going to the Apple menu, System Settings, General, and then Software Update. Generally speaking, it's a good idea to upgrade your Mac to the latest supported version of macOS. You'll receive the latest features, security improvements, and performance enhancements with few, if any, downsides. Before we talk about unsupported updates, let's go over the key features that have been introduced with each version of macOS since macOS 11 Big Sur, which was released in 2020 as the first OS available for Silicon Macs and the last OS available for many tried and true Intel Macs. It served as an entire overhaul of macOS, preparing Apple to optimize its OS builds for Apple's silicon chips. For this reason, Apple finally decided, after nearly 20 years, that it was time to move on from macOS 10, and finally released Big Sur as macOS 11. Following Big Sur in 2021, Apple released macOS 12, Monterey, which added universal control, the ability to seamlessly use your keyboard and mouse across multiple Macs and iPads. It also added AirPlay to Mac, which lets you stream content directly from your phone or iPad to your Mac's display. Great for presentations or watching videos, and I actually have a special use case for this feature that I'll discuss later on. Monterey also comes with focus modes to help minimize distractions for when you can't be bothered. In 2022, Apple released macOS 13 Ventura, which brought Stage Manager, a new way to organize and open windows and focus on the task at hand. Honestly, I don't use this feature and wouldn't recommend upgrading just for its sake. Continuity Camera, however, also released with Ventura, turns your iPhone into a webcam for your Mac, which can be very useful, especially for older Macs with lower quality cameras. Ventura also introduced the Freeform app for collaborative whiteboard brainstorming, passkeys in Safari for a more secure login experience, and handoff for FaceTime, basically allowing you to answer a FaceTime call on your phone and then seamlessly transfer it to your Mac where you've got a bigger screen. 2023 brought the release of macOS 14 Sonoma, which finally brought widgets back to the Mac desktop. There are seriously a lot of people who upgraded to Sonoma just for this feature. Widgets had been a classic feature of macOS, but were removed in 2019 with macOS 10.15 Catalina. Mac fans were not happy, and after 4 years of outcry from the community, Apple finally decided to bring the feature back and let users clutter their desktops to their heart's content once again. Sonoma also added video conferencing features such as presenter overlay, reactions, and improved screen sharing. In addition, Sonoma comes with Game Mode for more dedicated usage of the CPU and GPUs, and Safari Profiles for better privacy, organization, and customization. In 2024, Apple introduced macOS 15 Sequoia, which is available in beta and will be released publicly any day now. One of the biggest additions is iPhone mirroring, letting you fully control your iPhone right from your Mac, answer calls, send texts, use apps, the whole nine yards. Safari is getting smarter too, with a new highlights feature that helps you quickly find key information on web pages. If you have a newer Mac with an M series chip, you'll gain access to Apple's new built-in AI, Apple Intelligence, which will function as a full AI assistant, helping users complete tasks more efficiently. It makes use of Apple Neural Engine, a processing unit on Silicon Macs that speeds up machine learning. For this reason, Apple Intelligence won't be included as an available feature for Intel-based Macs. This should give you an idea of the new features you'll get with each new version of macOS. And in case you're wondering, yes, each new version of macOS comes with the features from previous builds. So like I said earlier, if your Mac is supported for upgrading, it usually doesn't hurt to do it. What if it's not supported though? As many of you know, I've installed unsupported versions of macOS on my own devices right here on YouTube. But the question is, should you do the same? Well, it depends. First of all, I really wouldn't recommend installing an unsupported version of macOS on your primary computer. Unsupported installations can be unstable, and they're almost always a little bit unpredictable. If there's a certain feature you need, however, that you can't work without, well, you gotta do what you gotta do. Just make sure you're doing a backup before you upgrade. For older Macs that are just lying around collecting dust, however, unsupported installations are the perfect solution. I actually wasn't using my 2013 MacBook Pro that much until I upgraded it to Sonoma, and now I use the screen mirroring feature for every single YouTube video I record. Yep, it's in front of me right now, right over there, making sure that my head doesn't veer off and out of the frame. I can see what I'm recording thanks to this feature on my unsupported installation. Before any major update, back up your Mac. Time Machine is a built-in option, you could use a cloud service or just a local external drive. I personally prefer a clean install when I'm upgrading to a new version of macOS. It keeps things fresh and helps avoid any lingering issues. I manually drag and drop my important files to an external drive, then wipe the Mac and install the new version of macOS from scratch before bringing my files back over. It takes a bit longer, but it's worth it for the improved performance and stability. It also encourages me to save more files in the cloud, which helps me avoid data loss in terms of any sort of catastrophic accident. I am currently using a 2020 iMac running macOS 14 Sonoma as my primary computer. It will be supported for upgrading to Sequoia, albeit without Apple Intelligence, and should also be supported for at least two more OS upgrades. Apple tends to drop support after 7 years. I love this computer because since it has an Intel chip, I have a local version of Windows installed on it with Bootcamp, which I use on a regular basis. Once it goes out of date, I'll have to either choose between Mac and Windows or build two separate systems or run Windows through virtualization through something like Parallels, and that's something that I really don't want to do. I also have a 2013 MacBook Pro running an unsupported version of Sonoma, which, like I said, I use for mirroring my iPhone and both screen and audio recording. Big Sur was the last supported OS for that computer and just didn't have the features that I needed for my secondary computer. So upgrading your version of macOS, especially when it's supported, can unlock new features and improve performance. Unsupported upgrades can breathe new life into otherwise useless machines. So if you can upgrade an unsupported Mac to the newest version of macOS, why doesn't Apple support it? Check out this video to find out why. Good luck finding the best version of macOS for your needs. I'm Anson Alexander, and I'll see you in the next one.